Quick. Run across there and check if they're friendly. All right. Welcome, young unconventional people.
Greg, we're frightened.
I know, I'm frightened too. But what we're going to do is we're going to get to know our unconventional young people by asking them their names. They're not frightening. What's your name, young fella?
Figures.
They're a little bit frightening. Figures.
That's right, yeah.
You an accountant? Do people say that all the time?
Yeah.
All the time?
All the time.
Oh, you're Australian.
I am Australian.
Get off. I'm kidding. Which part of Australia are you from?
Melbourne.
I've been to Melbourne.
Oh, do you like it?
Yes, I do, actually. I've been down to St Kilda and I've been at Fitzroy. You're from St Kilda, aren't you?
No, I'm not.
No, why not?
If you come from St Kilda, you are usually either a walker of the night or...
That's me.
Oh, okay.
Go up to the end there. Girls who were sitting in lesbian row. Are you from Australia too?
No, we're Canadian. Yes.
Good God. All of you?
Yeah, I'm Mexican.
You're Mexican?
Yes.
What happened?
What are you doing? I'm trying to get the folks at home not to be frightened of young people, and now you've just got them frightened of foreigners. And I've been working for years to get them off that. What are you doing here, my Canadian Mexican friends? What are you doing here?
We're on tour with our band.
You're in a band?
Yes. The three of us here. Yeah. We're all in the same band.
And she's
a musician too.
But you just, what?
We're friends, we're all friends.
Well, you like Scrappy Doo or something? What the hell? They don't let you in the band, but you get to hang out? Oh, bet you! You don't need to take that, you're a Canadian citizen.
Yeah. I have my own band.
She has her own.
Wait a minute, let me just check. Is there anyone here this evening who is not in a... I got a back. Figures, you're in a band, aren't you?
I am.
Do not plug this band. No, Figures. Please, do not do it.
Please, we're a comedy rock band as well.
We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Samsung Galaxy S3. The next big thing is already here. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson. Excited. This is the rowdiest crowd we have ever had at the studio. Rowdy! Greg, what do you mean by rowdy? Well, I'm using the slang term of rowdy to imply drunken stoners. Yes, I wonder why. It is, however, a great day for America, everybody.
Yes. Now, I know. Come on, Craig. You say it's a great day for America every night. Can't possibly be true. Well, that's true. But tonight it is. It is a great day for America. Why? Well, the election is almost over. Yay! Well done, everybody. In less than 24 hours, shut up, the polls will close. Do we have a graphic for the polls closing, do we? That's it? All right. So here we are again. The election has come down to undecided voters. Undecided voters. So if you're still undecided, what the f*** is wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Seriously, these guys have spent billions laying out totally different visions for our future. And you still haven't made your mind up? What's it gonna take? There's not a bikini competition. Is there a bikini competition? I wish.
That would be awesome.
That would be awesome. Make the bastards debate in their skivvies.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, personally, I can't wait to say goodbye to the election. And also to people who complain the election's going on too long. Wait, that's me. I just went through a self-loathing wormhole right there. You're welcome, stoners. Here in California, we get off pretty easy, but for those of you who live in swing states, I am terribly sorry. Your airwaves have been so clogged with negative ads, you'll be looking forward to getting back to regular ads. Seeing an ad for a piece of crap like the Slap Chop will be a breath of fresh air. But what if they've changed the ads to make them more negative, like attack ads in politics? You'll be like, the Dyson vacuum claims to have the proper amount of suction. But does it? Does it have the proper amount of suction? Under Obamacare, you won't be allowed to attach it to your penis. Evening, ladies. It's funny where your eye goes at the wrong time, isn't it, really? Anyway, everyone's been saying that this is the most negative election ever, and to them I say balderdash. Not because I disagree, I just like saying balderdash. You want to say
it? It's a great word.
It's a great balderdash. Say it.
Balderdash. Mm-hmm.
But today's mudslinging. Today's mudslinging is tame compared to the way it used to be. This is true. When Thomas Jefferson was running for president, he accused his opponent, John Adams, of being a hermaphrodite. Why Jefferson was such a genius. He used the word hermaphrodite. He could have just said double junk, but he didn't. By the way, double junk and balderdash, what were they?
They were like a vaudeville.
Vaudeville act, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, they were.
We should do a movie about them. I'll be double junk and you'll be balderdash.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, they were our main competition when we toured as Fiddlesticks and Poppycock.
I was poppycock. For obvious reasons.
Fiddlesticks.
Poppycock. That was our catchphrase. Let's do it again.
Yeah. Fiddlesticks.
Poppycock. Anyway, what am I doing? The election, yes, the 1820 election. In 1820, Andrew Jackson was repeatedly attacked in Whig pamphlets as, and I quote here, a gambler, a cockfighter, and the husband of a really fat wife. That's what it said. And I'm like, well, gambling is, I don't care about gambling, and cockfighting can be fun, trust me, but do not attack a man's wife, and you certainly do not comment on a woman's weight. That is why the Whigs did not get a single female vote in 1820. That and because women were not allowed to vote in 1820. What? Yeah. Take that, Whigs! I'm really giving it to the Whigs tonight, man.
Fiddlesticks. Poppycock.
I know what it
is. Yeah,
I was timing it.
Yeah,
don't tell me. Don't give me the line. I know the line.
We're going
do it again.
The wormhole again, man.
All right.
Fiddlesticks.
Poppycock.
And that's why we broke up.
Yep.
I'm trying to talk about these election campaigns. Martin Van Buren. Martin Van Buren's campaign, he was attacked terribly. And I'm not making this up either. He was the subject of a vicious rumor that he wore women's lingerie. No, true. Hecklers would yell, "He be laced up in lady corsets." And then, after Martin Van Buren became the 13th president of these United States, he surprised everyone with his official White House portrait. Have you got that? Look at that. Wait. I think, and this is the weird part, Jeff, I sensed quite a lot of arousal in the studio audience there. Oh,
Martin Van Buren, more like Martin Van Booty. And that's why we broke up.
Yeah. Here in California, we've been getting phone calls asking who we're going to vote for. I got one last night. It wasn't an official poll, it was just Larry King. He's calling everyone in California.
And that's why we broke up.
Oh, yes. He's like, "This is Larry King. Are you thinking about pulling the lever tomorrow? What about voting? Are you going to do that?"
And that's why we broke up.
Yeah.
Anyway, no matter which candidate you support, I urge you to take time and vote tomorrow. And be extra nice to the volunteers at the polling place. If you're nice to them, who knows, maybe they'll let you vote twice. They will in Chicago. Are you ready? Have you voted?
Oh yeah.
Have you voted? Or do you do the postal? Did you mail your vote?
Yeah, I did it by mail, yeah.
You do it by mail?
Oh yeah.
You do most things by mail, don't you?
You know I do.
Yeah, you do. So do you discuss your voting?
No.
No, you never do?
Never discuss.
I'm going Whig again this year.
Oh, you're going Whig?
No, I'm anti-Whig.
All right. Okay.
So are you anti-Whig or pro-Whig?
No, I'm pro-Whig, man.
No, I think we're both anti-Whig.
Okay, yeah, that's what we are. And that's how we stay together.
We agree on everything. Fiddlesticks.
Poppycock.
We turned it around. Do the thing, Jeff. Yep.
Craig Ferguson says he only has one testicle, but that's because he's a hermaphrodite. Vote for someone who has neither. Vote Peterson.
Larry King's presidential election history.
In the presidential election of 1824, Andrew Jackson received a plurality, but not a majority, of the electoral votes. The vote was given to the House of Representatives, which chose John Quincy Adams. Okay, I made that all up, but I just like being on television.
Tonight, the audience is made up exclusively of people who are from other countries and in band. You know, I want a house band here. Remember I was talking to you about that, Jeff?
Yeah.
I want a house band here. And you know who I want? I want Richie Sambora from Bon Jovi. That's who
I want. Yeah, man. Yeah.
Richie Sambora. You get me Sambora. Get me some, and I don't want the rest of Bon Jovi, just Richie.
Just Richie playing bongos. That's what
he can play
said.
Guitar too. He can play guitar.
All right, okay.
He's like,
what the hell?
Yeah, that's like Sambora is a master of the. I'm very excited because the deer are on tonight. That's what it is.
Oh,
you know
yeah.
That, right?
Man. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. What do the D do, Jeff? What do the D, Tenacious D, what do they do?
Oh, they rock out.
They rock is what they do.
Oh, yeah.
Craig, what are you doing? I'm throwing the goat.
What time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
Well, it's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who created more American jobs this year by hiring homeless people to sit in the audience.
Did I do that?
Yeah, you did, yeah.
All right, this is from... Oh, gosh, it's another one from Melbourne, Australia.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, it's from Susan. You can... She's a very attractive woman. From Melbourne, Australia. Dear Craig, it's time to stop talking and get on down under and run this damn country already. Oh, yeah. I had this dream about, was it 2 weeks ago?
Yeah.
That I was the Prime Minister of Australia. And I talked about it on the show, and up to 4 or 5 Australians have said, you know, we're into this. But here's the thing. A, I'm not an Australian, I'm an American citizen, and B, my policy on kangaroos has been very flip-floppy.
That's true, you've gone back and forth on that.
I've gone back and forth on the whole marsupial question. this is from Justin in Massachusetts, who says, Dear Craig and Jeff, what part of Italy does Italian Bill Clinton come from? Oh, yeah, because I do Italian Bill Clinton.
Yeah, it's a great impression.
Thanks very much. Will I do it now?
Yeah, love it.
All right, then.
What's a coming to go?
Italian Bill Clinton.
Yeah, yeah, it's great.
Jeff,
great.
Jeff. Do you do a Bill Clinton from another country?
A Bill Clinton from another country?
Yes, it has to be a Bill Clinton from another country. The only Bill Clintons we do here are Bill Clintons from another country.
All right,
I do Italian Bill Clinton, and I do German Bill Clinton.
Yeah, do the German. That's very good.
Achtung, baby.
Wow.
What do you do?
Now, you want me to do Bill Clinton?
What, you do Italian Bill Clinton?
No, I'll do Australian Bill Clinton.
Australian Bill Clinton. Very good. On you go, then.
Hi. Why don't you put another shrimp on the Barbie, baby?
Very good. Very good. Secretariat, do you do a Bill Clinton from another country? You do. On you go, then. Yeah, it's great. That's great. That horse is so high. this is from Bridgie in Setucket in New York, who says, Dear Craig and Jeff, please tell my boyfriend to finally assemble his bed frame. I'm tired of sleeping on the floor. Jeff, would you...
Hey, what the hell, man? Get to it, lazy ass.
No, I tell you what, Jeff. Tell the boyfriend to assemble the bed frame as Liam Neeson in Taken.
Oh, good, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. I don't know who you are, but I will find you, and I will assemble that bed. Do it, quickly! No, there's no time!
There we go.
Quickly!
there's only one left. I managed to drop two by accident. This is from Barry in Redding in California. You ever been there?
Yeah,
in California?
Love it there.
Got a little place there, man.
Yeah, a little cycle. I go swimming.
What do you do? Well, you go swimming?
I get naked. Sure. Yeah. Hell yeah.
Dear Craig and Jeff, my name is Barry from Redding, California. I was just wondering how many neckties you have. Really? I don't actually own any neckties.
You don't have one single necktie?
Not one. You know why?
Why is that?
I rent. I rent my neckties. You know why?
Why?
Earthquakes.
That's true, Craig. If you're on the way out the house, don't have time to grab those neckties.
That's right, Jeff. And what happens when the big one strikes?
You're out of neckties.
Oh, Jeff. It's like you know me.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, listen. We're very out of time here.
Oh dear.
Oh boy.
Oh dear.
Yeah, a lot of tension over there.
Uh-oh.
Oh no.
This is tension.
Oh, a lot of tension. Yeah, this is sign language for tension.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you ever see there's also another they see that sign? You see that sign?
Had to do it.
Yeah. That sign that's the American sign language sign for pixelation. Did you know that?
Talk to those hands.
All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody.
first guest tonight are the self-proclaimed greatest band in the world. Their new album, Jazz, is available on Friday, November the 23rd. Yeah. Please welcome Jack Black and Kyle Glass. Tenacious D, everybody. I'm very excited about this album. I haven't had a chance to listen to it yet, but I'm very excited because you rock, gentlemen. You rock, if I may say so.
No. Not anymore. Now we jazz. I don't know if you looked. You didn't even take time to look at the title.
Yeah, I thought it was an ironic use of the word jazz.
Oh no! That's Tenacious D jazz, as in old school real time jazz, and we're taking it very seriously.
yeah. Well, you know, like jazz, like with berets and black turtlenecks. Oh my God!
Okay. We expected there to be some discomfort at the new direction that we're taking.
Yes. But,
we hope that you'll respect our new direction and respect our courage and our conviction in moving into a new dimension of sound.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, sir, but I absolutely will not respect your new direction. I do not care for it one bit. You must rock a little bit.
Rock is dead, Craig.
Yeah.
Excuse me, Mr. Al Qaeda? You can't say that. Rock is not dead.
Hurt your feelings, Craig. You know it'd be true. No, rock is dead, but the good news is jazz is back in a big way. And leading the charge are Tenacious D. Bringing back the magic, the majesty, the subtlety, and the exploration of jazz.
Look, I have no doubt that there are extremely talented musicians involved in jazz. I know it's a musical form that a lot of people enjoy. I, however, am not one of those people. Jazz, to me, sounds like 11 different guys in a band all playing a different tune. Mm.
You know, it's not for everyone, but if you really open up your heart and soul to the music, you'll see that it's the science of sound. And we're dealing with a kind of...
Freedom, really.
Freedom. Jazz... I mean, when we first started realizing that we had jazz locked up inside us and we had to release it, it was in a sound check. Mm-hmm. We were just in between songs, rehearsing songs, and then we just started sort of experimenting with the sound of jazz. And we realized this is the work of genius. And we've got to just embrace it fully.
This sounds like, you know, one of those stories in Penthouse where the girls get snowed in the cabin. And then they start experimenting with their sexuality. And then, maybe I'm the only one that's seeing this analogy here, but you know where I'm going.
Well, our inspirations, who would you say are the people that really inspired us in this realm?
Oh, gosh, you didn't.
You go Miles Davis.
Coltrane.
You go David Lee Roth. You go Franz Kafka.
Franz Kafka?
Yeah.
Franz Kafka was a musical buffoon, sir.
No. He was also a jazz artiste.
Was he
on
really?
The side.
Is that true?
Yep, that's actually true.
Really? What
and,
did he play?
He played the bassoon. But, Now,
let's stay with Kafka for a minute, Jack. Let's find out. The bassoon, you say?
Well, tonight...
What kind of bassoon?
It was the tenor bassoon. But,
It's not a real thing.
The thing is, we are abandoning our guitars. We're focusing on vocal music, and I do play the trombone, but I left it out in the rain, and now it's gotten a little rusty.
Rusty trombone, yeah.
But I still do play it, and I play it quite forcefully. Yeah. But yeah, we played our last rock show just a few days ago.
This is not real, right? I mean, you're not...
No, this is real. This album comes out on November 23rd, and we put our hearts and souls into it, and I hope you'll give it a chance.
No, I'll give it a chance. I'm not really, but I'm just trying to be nice.
It's Black Friday, right? The day
Black
after.
Friday, yeah.
Yeah.
Black Friday?
That's the independent vinyl day for
record store
day, so you can get it. It's only available on vinyl for the highest possible
fidelity. I think that's wise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's a perfect stocking stuffer, as you can see. Just stuff it right in there if you get a big square stocking.
Yeah, yeah. Do you know what I thought was weird?
Mm.
Like yesterday when I went to the cinema and you were there and I was there?
That was weird.
That was weird, right?
Yeah. Well, what was weird is I saw you. I haven't seen you in like years.
Right.
And then yesterday in the morning I saw you at like a buffet.
Right, we went to a brunch.
Oh my God, I'm gonna be on your show tomorrow.
I know, and it was like, oh no,
and then later that same day, I was with my kids at a movie and you were there at the movie.
Right, following you around.
This is true.
Really?
This actually is true, this
what
really
were you
happened.
Saying?
Well, we went to see the movie for the kids. It was great.
It was the thing with the video game.
What was the...
Wreck-It Ralph,
yeah.
Oh, John C. Reilly.
I was going to call it Big Hammer Mike, but you know what I mean. Wreck-It Ralph, that's right. Did you enjoy it?
Yes, the kids
I saw your kids
it.
Dancing down front at the end credits.
Yeah, well, my 4-year-old, actually, right at the very end, he took off his glasses, but then he wanted to put them back on, and he put them back on really fast, and he poked his eye, and he was screaming and crying, and we had to take him outside of the theater for a while to calm down. So it kind of ruined the whole experience, but... But yes, my older son did dance. He likes to go up and dance in front of the audience at the movie theater. It was very nice.
Yeah, I have no idea where that comes from. So, listen to me. You're going to come back and play some of this jazz for us later in the show, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's no fingers about it, though. It's real jazz.
It's going to be like you're going to start off jazz and then it'll turn into rock.
Yeah. What? No.
We can't plan it. We don't know where it's going. I mean, it's all improvisational.
Here's the thing that's bugging me about this.
I don't like improv.
You're really attacking our art form, and I have to say that this is the same thing that Bob Dylan had to deal with when he went electric. People booed, and they laughed, and they pointed, and they mocked. But when they realized that he was forging a new thingy, they got on board. And, you know...
All right. I'll keep an open mind.
2 years from now, when jazz has taken over the popular music scene, you'll look back to this day and you'll say, maybe I shouldn't have laughed so hard. I was on the wrong side of history when it came to jazz.
All right, we'll give it a shot. Tenacious D will be back. A beautiful actress who will be a guest starring on Chicago Fire, which airs Wednesday nights on, what is it?
NBC.
NBC. The lovely Sarah Shahi, everybody. Sarah Shahi.
Yes.
Sarah, a lot of people at home will be wondering why you didn't do the talk show walk across from there over to there, and then everyone can look at your legs, which I'm doing now. Why did you not walk across? You have a sore foot?
I do. I did this marathon over the weekend it was a fundraiser for cancer.
Like a real marathon?
Like a real marathon.
26 miles? 24 miles, whatever it is.
Let me start over. My definition of a marathon is running anything more than 2 minutes.
Okay.
So this was a 5K.
That's not a marathon.
But hey, man. Hey, it was for me.
Don't hey, man, me. It's like people have gone jazz crazy. Like the audience is clicking their fingers. You're calling me. Are you a jazz fan?
Oh, love jazz. Love blues. And I heard you play a mouth organ that I want you to blow. A little bit later.
I also play the harmonica. You really are a fan of jazz?
Yeah, no, I am. I did this movie in New Orleans last summer, and I got really into the blues, and every now we went out to a different jazz blues bar, and the harmonica just really kind of just got into my blood.
Yeah, it's good. Do you play yourself?
I just got one, though, and I want to learn. So maybe you could be my teacher.
No, I can't. Maybe I could. Is that the sore leg?
Yes, the doctor told me to elevate it, so here we go. No. Late, late show, right?
It is now. Yeah. It is now. I like your dress. It's very sparkly.
You know what? Some girls are just bored with more glitter. I rehearsed that bit. I was hoping it worked.
Yeah, no. Here's the thing about this show. Anything rehearsed is going to stand out pretty badly.
Yeah.
So be careful. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
Now, how are things with you? You've got a little 3-year-old.
I do.
All right. A human 3-year-old human. It's not like a 3-year-old child.
No, yeah. No, it's a human.
Yeah.
And like, do you ever have those moments where you just go, why?
Usually during the monologue, actually. But, Yeah.
I do.
It happens a lot. Yeah.
Yeah, I have a 3-year-old son who's the love of my life.
Yes, of course. They're lovely, but
he's in your green room right now, eating up all your chocolate, terrorizing everybody.
It's not. Well, the thing is to remember, it's not my chocolate. I don't think. Is it mine technically? Because I'll take it if it is mine. I don't think it's mine. I think it's a CBS chocolate. Did they give you chocolate at NBC?
They did give me lots of chocolate.
Really? And what's the show you're on? Yeah. Chicago Fire?
I'm doing a guest spot right now on Chicago Fire.
Right. And what's the show? Is it Firefighters?
Firefighters. More specifically, I play Taylor Kinney's girlfriend.
Right.
And he's just hot. He's just H-O-T.
You're telling me, girl.
Oh, there's a horse in the corner. Very late
yeah,
night.
Yeah,
related.
No, yes. That's how he passes the time.
Do you have a Kleenex next to you?
Wait. You set him off at a creepy
moment. Oh, wow.
What do you do in this fire time show? What's it called again? Fire?
Chicago Fire.
Yeah. So, do you play the girlfriend of the hot firefighter?
Yeah, I get
nice
to make
job.
Out with
yeah,
lot.
You make out with him?
Yeah, a lot.
Nice. Do you do any firefighting?
I'm glad you guys had booze back there.
You have booze back there? Really? I didn't know we had booze back there. I don't encourage that either. I mean, what the hell's going on here? Kids running around eating candy and there's booze back there? And the hell is going on? We're going to have the
oh, my God. What's going on?
That's Jeff.
Where am I? What? Who's that guy?
I'll tell you one thing, I'm not gay anymore.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't know, man. I think if the firefighter was here, you'd be right back to where you started.
That's your gay robot friend?
He's my gay robot skeleton pal. Yeah, he's my buddy. We go back a long way. How long did we go back to?
20, 30 years.
20, 30 years. Yeah, we were in vaudeville together. I was poppycock and he was stick it out. What was it?
Fiddlesticks. Easy. Yeah.
What?
Oh, my
Fiddlesticks.
God.
Fiddlesticks, yeah. Fiddlesticks and poppycock, yeah. Well, you never heard of us? We were the Tenacious D of our time.
Right, of course. Yeah, yes. Very excited to see them.
Yeah, no, good, because they'll be coming up next. We're out of time. Do you want a piece of fruit?
I would love a piece of fruit.
What do you fancy?
A banana.
Okay, yeah. There you are. It leans a bit to one side, but you'll be all right. Welcome back, everybody. I'm very excited because Tenacious D will be performing tonight. Simply Jazz off their album Jazz. Now, no, it's Simply Jazz here on the album. It says it's 11 minutes 36 seconds long. We don't have that kind of real estate to give away. So, when the horse comes out, that's the end of your jazz freeform expression time. Is that all right?
You do it. Check, 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 putty, putty, one, two, three. Am I on here? Can you hear me? You do whatever you need to do.
When time is up, you come out. Well, I'm very excited about this. Please welcome Tenacious D, everybody!
No meaning. 24 hours of non-stop jazz. Succulent jazz, flavor adventure. It tastes like honeysuckle dewdrops on the breeze of ancient nations. Rusty.